Lieutenant Eric Kelly has been on the Memphis Police Force since 1993, until last fall. He suddenly retired while under fire for having a sexual relationship with a woman he believed had ties to a murder he was investigating. WREG found out this wasn't the first time Kelly's conduct was called into question. In fact, he's been accused of violating policy around 40 different times. Supervisors said there was insufficient evidence for about half of them, but he was suspended multiple times, including in 1997, after he pulled a man over for speeding and reportedly confiscated drugs and money. Kelly lied about whether he counted the cash, and the man claimed he had more money than what was tagged as evidence. The disciplinary report noted already in his career he had 5 citizen complaints within a 4-month span, stating there was a need for stronger corrective action. A year later, that happened, when Kelly was accused of repeatedly hitting a juvenile at Ridgecrest Apartments. Supervisors stated he had a pattern of behavior that is not acceptable. Kelly was terminated. But it didn't stick. He got his job back after reportedly appealing to the city's Civil Service Commission. Councilman Worth Morgan.
The concern is there's just been enough stories, including the Eric Kelly case, that have been both reported in the media and around here at City Hall, where there's been due process and there's been just cause to terminate someone's employment. They appeal it to civil service or arbitration, and then they're reinstated.
And what's worse is Morgan says some of the employees continue to behave poorly.
Seems like it's more difficult to terminate a bad employee here than it is anywhere else in the city.
Kelly's conduct was repeatedly questioned after he got his job back, getting suspended time and time again for violating department policy up until his retirement.
It may be time to have a conversation, I think, with the administration